So I welcome all of you for the first lecture on the under the Prerna scheme on construction technology. Okay, so regarding Prerna scheme, I'm happy to inform you that regarding the Prerna scheme, we have received a grant of total almost 6 lakh rupees under which we are preparing our students, third year and final year students, for the preparation of higher education. And the gate we have chosen, under the gate subjects we will be delivering the contents. We have divided the entire gate syllabus into number of contents, and in the contents we will deliver the segment by segment. So third year students and final year students will be getting the benefit of it. So I appeal all students to attend this in maximum numbers, as today there are students attending number is very good and very handsome. So I hope that till the end of the scheme every student will attend with the full zeal. All right, so this is the first lecture. Okay, and today we will see in the segment of construction material management, we will today see the construction management, types of construction and projects. Basically, what GATE deals with? GATE deals with the concepts, GATE deals with the methods, and GATE deals with the short tricks of solving the numericals. In RTMNO examination, people are solving the exam by normal method, but in the GATE, they are same kind of numerical but with different technique, different way. But the time limit is only of 1 minute. In a GATE examination, you are not supposed to waste 5 minutes for a one question. No, it will not serve the purpose. You need to identify shortcut trick that we'll deal here. Okay, and before applying shortcut trick, the basics we should know. But as far as this domain is concerned of construction material management, only CPM and PERT numericals are there. So we will see actual numerical, but in my third lecture. But in this today's first lecture, we will see construction management. What is construction management? Before management, what is project? What are construction projects? And what is management? All right. So I hope you understood this, and we'll try now to extract all the things from this concept. Okay. So again, I would have to repeat that in this segment of GATE, theoretical questions are expected, where we must have a brief knowledge regarding the management. We must have a brief knowledge regarding projects, types of project, funding project. Okay. So as I have used the term, okay. Very important one. I am showing here the reference books. This is very important. What reference book we should follow? It is very important. So purify. But I have highlighted red. I am using that only. So if you people can have this MC Grohan Hills, then Dr. UK Srivastava, then DC Punmiya. These are all good books so that the thorough knowledge can be acquired. All right. So project. Okay. The moment I pronounce the word project, things may start bubbling in your mind regarding our undergraduate project. Regarding our MTech project. So project, what a project can be defined as? What is a project? Project can be, it's a set of tasks, set of instruction, a task to be carried out by a group of people or individual to achieve something. It has some well-defined objectives. It has some well-defined aim. It has a vision. It has a mission. That is project. It might be a construction of building is a project. Construction of road is a project. Okay. Preparation of hospital for corona is a project. So project means is a set of tasks, set of activities, that is a project. Okay, so we'll further see it. What is project? In simple, to understand project, a project is a temporary endeavor undertaken to create a unique product or service. Project is a temporary endeavor undertaken to create a unique product or a service. Project can be large or small. As I given you the example, it may be a construction of road, it may be a construction of small house, or it may be a construction of hospital for 1,000 beds in this COVID pandemic situation. So we need to understand the project, what exactly it is. It may take small time to complete, or it may take too much time to complete. This is project. All right. Now, its attributes and its characteristics. Project has a unique purpose. As I said earlier, it should have a purpose. It should have a starting. It should have an ending. Okay. So it has a unique purpose. Every project should have a well-defined objective. Each project has a definite beginning and definite end. Require resources often from various areas. For example, the project of construction of house, we require different skill set. We require the skilled manpower, we require labor, technicians, machineries, tools, it requires resources, okay, and should have a primary customer or a sponsor. Basically, what project to be understand, it is the project is something which is a solution is to be provided on the identified problem. For example, I have to launch something in the market. Let us consider the example. I have to launch something in the market, and before launching anything in the market, I should analyze the market problem, market condition, market demand. Okay, and then I should launch. So it should have a certain primary customer. It means it should have a demand, should have a sponsor, and project always involves uncertainty. Uncertainty. Okay, this is about the project attributes and characteristics. Okay. Then now, in the continuation of management, I would like to add something that the as we have defined very smoothly the project, it's a set of activities and set of tasks to be performed. So management can be defined in various ways. So by I am just putting the two or three authors here: Donald Cuff, Henry Fayol, Peter Drucker. So what Donald Cuff said that it may be as a gate question in by giving such the name of the authors. A gate exam may ask you to choose proper sentence given by the proper author. So such kind of exam, such kind of questions may appear in the examination. So Donald Cuff told that the management is the art and science of decision making and leadership. So as per Donald Cuff, it's the art and science of making the decision and the leadership. But as for Henry Fayol, management is asked to manage, is to forecast and to plan. Organize, to command and to coordinate and to control. So we have added the six segments. First will be the forecast, the plan, organize, command, coordinate and control. But as for Peter Drucker, the management is a multi-purpose organ that manages a business and managers, that manages business and manages managers and manages workers and work. Okay, so we need to, you know, very carefully keep we should keep all these things in mind. And this kind of tricky questions or this kind of confusing questions always appear in the gate examination. Now, once we understand project, set of activities, different skills required, manpower required, now we'll try to understand what is project management. Okay, in our civil engineering, in the big projects, we have a person called project manager. So what his role and responsibility will deal further. But now we'll try to understand what is project management. So project management is the application of knowledge, skills, tools, and techniques to project activities to meet the requirement of the project. So basically, project management is nothing but the application of knowledge, skill sets, tools to the taken project, but set of activities, set of tasks. All right. So it is the application of knowledge, skills, tools, and techniques to. So sort I have sorted out the technical issue and I will now present the screen. I hope you have my screen is visible. I hope my screen is visible to you. So we have two types of the national, international, non-industrial, industrial. All right. So non-conventional R&D, high technology, conventional technology and low technology. So there are classifications, no problem, there are classifications. Okay, so in the high technology, we have mega project, we have minor project, we have medium project, and we have mini project. Just like in our curriculum, we have mini project, major project, we have mega project, medium. So in the mega project, we have grassroots expansion or modification, for example, and expansion, we have crash disaster projects or normal projects. So project life cycle. Now we are about to deal with the project life cycle. So see, basically I am dealing a theory with you because in this segment of construction technology management, basically only the theory part is not okay. Numericals are there, very less amount. We need to make our theory concept very strong in order to pick proper objectives, proper MCQ. So in the multiple choice question of the gate examination, we need to pick proper options so that we must have a theory knowledge of the project management. Okay, So in the project life cycle, a project life cycle is a collection of project phases that defines what work to be performed in each phase, what deliverable will be produced or and when, who to involve, who not to involve, and how management will control and approve the work produced in each of the phase. All right, a deliverable product or service produced or provided as a part of project. Okay. Now, very important, I request everyone to grab, and I want to grab your attention to this diagram. There are phases of project life cycles. First one as project initiation, then planning, then execution, then closure. So in the four major segments of the project, initiation, planning, execution, and closure, there are again four subcategories, such as after initiating the project has to be defined. Unless and until you define the project, you are not supposed to plan the project. And once you plan, you must have a detailed planning. Then after planning, when execution start, and you must have monitoring and control. And with all activities now, it is the time to close the project. And afterwards, post-presentation review has to be there. So this diagram is itself a self-explanatory diagram. And you can see the all phases. Okay, project initiation, project planning, project execution, and project closure. So in the project initiation, once the project has initiated, it has to be a proper definition. The roles, responsibility, aim, objective should be very clear. After initiation, project planning has to be there. Once we have planning, once we start the planning, we must have a detailed thorough planning. And then while before starting or once it has started execution. So once we have started the execution with the help of proper monitoring and control, we should close the project, and after closing the project, we must have the post-implementation review. Okay, in the meantime, we have initiation, planning, acquisition, operation, and then termination. Okay. So now, just now I have explained you the five phases. Even you can take this screenshot for your further studies. Project initiation, what we have to do in the initiation, we have seen the project planning, then execution. Okay, then the project monitoring and control. This phase step is very important. In the while once we start the project, and the project monitoring and the control is very important, because if anything goes wrong, we come to know only from the time to time monitoring. Okay, so project monitoring and control is very important, and after that the project closure. Okay, so project initiation, project planning, project execution, project monitoring and control, and project closure. So these are the things are very much important. All right, so moving further, now we will see conception. So first phase includes determine existing needs, establish system, and check technical feasibility, examine alternatives, and which defines the firm identification of a human and non-human respectively. Build pre-off detailed plan, determination of cost. All right, the production, operation, divestment or termination, it's called as. So in the production, testing and final standardization of the efforts so that operation can begin. Then if project is marketable product, then this phase includes life cycle phase of market introduction, growth, maturity, and portion of deterioration. Divestment includes the real location of resources. Okay. So now we have seen the project. Now we have seen the project. We have seen the organization. But we will now begin with the organization. So we have seen the project. We have seen the project, and just now we have seen. Am I audible? Hello? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
So we have seen project. Then we have seen with the management. Final year students may aware of these things, but those who are in third year, this concept will be new and they will be learning this in next year. So I want the full attention of the third year students. So once we know the project, what kind of projects are there, types of project, funding, then the types, categorization of the project. Then afterwards, we have seen the management, types of management. And now we will see the organization. Well, this is the part of project management. Okay. So what is our organization? So organization is a group of person working together to achieve a predefined goal. I want to request to everybody to focus on the sentence that organization is a group of person working together to achieve a predefined goal. So I want to give more emphasis on predefined goal word, because the in the project the aim is to be well defined. It should be very clear. And as we have always said that it's the number of people, those who are working together to achieve the goal. That is the organization. Okay. Defining a delegating responsibility and authority, establishing a leadership. Okay, this is the role of the organization. And for what it is important, a good organization which has facilitated both management and operation of the enterprise. It stimulates dependent and creative thinking, permits optimism use of technical and human resources, leads to specialization, minimize corruption and inefficiencies, does not generate confusion, less wastage and expenditure. So that's the role of the organization. That is the importance of the organization. Okay. Now we'll see principle of organization. So students, we are moving with some good average momentum speed. So those who have any doubts, they can raise the doubts so that we can solve the query also. Because for the preparation of the GATE examination, the concepts are very important than mugging up the thing. So your concept should be clear. Okay, so I just take a 1 minute break and I'll ask all of you whether you are getting all the things. Shall we move further?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So I hope the screen is visible, clear. So now the principles of organization. Just now we have seen the importance, and now we will see the principles of organization. So the first principle is the consideration of objectives, the relationship of basic components of organization, responsibility and authority, the span of control, dividing and grouping work, effective delegation, transparent communication, line and staff relationship, then balance, stability and flexibility. Okay. These are the main roles of the organization. So consideration of objectives, consider that objectives which increase productivity and improve quality. Okay, relationship of basic components of the organization. Okay, objective determine types of work which decide selection of personal and physical facilities. Okay. Then responsibility and authority. In responsibility and authority, responsibility means accountability and authority means right or power of act. For example, I have been given some portfolio from my organization. So I am accountable for answering the failure and success of the concerned portfolio. Okay. So it must go together. When a person is authorized, then he is told, he is held responsible for its performance. Span of control. Number of support that supports to execute, or number of support that an executive can supervise directly. It's way from 2 to 20. Then line and staff relationship. So in which we have to all activities in two types. First one is the primary act or line function are directly contribute to the objectives, and supporting acts or a staff function add to the line function. And finally, last but not the least, we are again have a few points. Balance, stability and flexibility. All units should be balanced in the organization, in the institute, in the industry. A stability refers to capacity to withstand the losses. Flexibility specifies to adjust the work assignments. Okay, and finally, what is authority? Authority means right to command and power to act, which empowers superior to make subordinate to the work. And right to make any decision, direct the work to others, can transfer any portfolio work to other, and give orders, and rightful for legal power. Now we will see again. We will see in short. Then types of organization, line, military scale. We will see in short. This is just for the various we have given. These are having some line military, functional organization, line of staff, organization is having some advantages. And since one foreman is responsible for one function, he can perform duty in a better manner. Okay. For example, I allot the same work to 10 people, they may confuse, juggling may be there. So the productivity is not supposed to increase. Okay. So reduce less number of accidents, it can save the wastages or avoid wastages, and quality of work can be improved. But in such cases, it is also at the same time, it is difficult to maintain that discipline. Work remain confused about the authority and difficult to fix up the responsibilities. Okay. Then absolute in moderate form used to advance concern. Now, in the continuation of management, I would like to add something that the as we have defined very smoothly the project, it's a set of activities and set of tasks to be performed. So management can be defined in various ways. So I'm just putting the two or three authors here, Donald Cuff, Henry Fayol, Peter Drucker. So what Donald Cuff said that it may be as a gate question by giving such the name of the authors, a gate exam may ask you to choose proper sentence given by the proper author. So such kind of exam, such kind of questions may appear in the examination. So Donald Cuff told that the management is the art and science of decision making and leadership. So as per Donald Cuff, it's the art and science of making the decision and the leadership. But as for Henry Fayol, management is as to manage, is to forecast and to plan, organize, to command and to coordinate and to control. So we have added the six segments. First will be the forecast, the plan, organize, command, coordinate and control. But as for Peter Drucker, the management is a multi-purpose organ that manages a business and managers, that manages business and manages managers and manages workers and work. Okay, so we need to, you know, very carefully keep all these things in mind. And this kind of tricky questions or this kind of confusing questions always appear in the GATE examination. And I can tell you one specialty of GATE is that in the GATE examination, they never ask repeated question. Topic will be same, domain will be same, but in the GATE examination, they will not ask specifically the same question again and again. Okay. In the university exam, it may happen. That question value may be changed, few modifications they have done. Okay. And it may there, but in GATE examination, there is very less chance of the repetition of the questions. So we need to study of GATE from syllabus point of view, not from the previous questionnaire point of view. Okay. So we have seen this management importance. We have seen functions, forecasting, planning, organization, staffing, direction, indirection, leadership, communication, motivation, supervision, subordinating, controlling, decision making. Okay. What we have seen in forecasting, which estimates the work, production planning, manager has to anticipate the future and discover alternatives, systematic way of decision making, it has to be there, essential, and utilization of the available resources, facilities, in organizing people, material, job, in staffing, selection of trained manpower, to promote the manpower, develop the manpower, training the manpower, hiring the manpower. Okay, in direction, we have motivating, guiding, supervising subordinates, it involves leadership, communication, a transparent way of communication has to be there. Leadership to be very strong. There should not be any favoritism or lobbying the things which can ultimately affect the productivity. Ineffective communication may lead to confusion, misunderstanding, dissatisfaction, and strikes. Okay, generally we listen such kind of things. Okay, in the industries, motivation should be there. Supervision, it has to be there. Inspiration should be there. There has to be some concept of incentives, promotion. Okay, work is going as per plan. Supervision, what kind of supervision should be there? The work is going as per the plan. Workers are doing, so they are directed. Okay, the subordinating, controlling, decision making. So this is all about the entire discussion regarding projects, types of projects, management, types of management, principles, use of management, role of management, and organization chart. So now the forum is open for the discussion. If anybody is having any doubt, a student may ask, and I will be very happy to answer all the things. So just now we'll take the recap. In the meantime, we will start asking the questions. The forum is now open. Now, very important, I request everyone to grab, and I want to grab your attention to this diagram. There are phases of project life cycles. First one as project initiation, then planning, then execution, then closure. So in the four major segments of the project, initiation, planning, execution, and closure, there are again four subcategories, such as after initiating the project, project has to be defined. Unless and until you define the project, you are not supposed to plan the project. And once you plan, you must have a detailed planning. Then after planning, when execution start, and you must have monitoring and control. And with all activities now, it is the time to close the project. And afterwards, post-presentation review has to be there. So this diagram is itself a self-explanatory diagram. And you can see the all phases. Okay, project initiation, project planning, project execution, and project closure. So in the project initiation, once the project has initiated, it has to be a proper definition. The roles, responsibility, aim, objective should be very clear. After initiation, project planning has to be there. Once we have planning, once we start the planning, we must have a detailed, thorough planning. And then while before starting, or once it has started execution, so once we have started the execution with the help of proper monitoring and control, we should close the project. And after closing the project, we must have the post implementation review. Okay, so in the meantime, we have initiation, planning, acquisition, operation, and then termination. Okay, so now just now I have explained the five phases. Even you can take this screenshot for your further studies. Project initiation, what we have to do in the initiation, we have seen the project planning, then execution, okay, then the project monitoring and control. This step is very important. In the while once we start the project, and the project monitoring and the control is very important, because if anything goes wrong, we come to know only from the time to time monitoring. Okay, so project monitoring and control is very important, and after that the project closure. Okay, so project initiation, project planning, project execution, project monitoring and control, and project closure. So these are the things are very much important. All right, so moving further, now we'll see conception. So first phase includes determine existing needs, establish system, and check technical feasibility, examine alternatives, and which defines the form identification of a human and non-human respectively. Build pre-op detailed plan, determination of cost. All right, the production, operation, divestment, or termination, it's called as. So in the production, testing and final standardization of the efforts so that operation can begin. Then if project is marketable product, then this phase includes life cycle phase of market introduction, growth, maturity, and portion of deterioration. Divestment includes the real location of resources. So this is the first lecture under Prerna scheme, and we have just started with the segment. My segment will be construction management and law. In that, we are seeing construction material and management. It is the part of CML, construction management and law subject, one segment. And today's lecture, we have covered construction management, types of projects, types of construction projects, okay, funding, etc. Reference books I have shown. Then projects, what thinking we should develop when we heard project that we have discussed. What is the project? Set of activities, set of tasks, a temporary individual, it has a start, it has an ending. Attributes of the project, project management. Okay. The categories, national, international, mega, minor. Okay, we have seen that. Project life cycle we have seen. And four segments we are seeing: initiation, planning, further discussion we have done. Further discussion we have done. Then the initiation, planning, then conception. Okay, then we have moved to organization. In the organization, we have some importance, principles. Okay, then authority, types of organization, the management. Again, we are just taking recap, importance of management, functions of management. Then we have details. So I hope the today's lecture, we have students, you have understood it. Now the forum is open for the discussion, and I want that you should have a two-way interaction. I want you people to have the proper doubts, because I believe in one thing, that if you try to understand, you will have doubts. Okay, so any doubt, students? So formally, I concluded that my lecture is over here. Now the forum is open for discussion. Think that the as we have defined very smoothly the project, it's a set of activities and set of tasks to be performed. So management can be defined in various ways. So by I am just putting the two or three authors here: Donald Cuff, Henry Fayol, Peter Drucker. So what Donald Cuff said that it may be as a gate question as in by giving such the name of the authors, a gate exam may ask you to choose proper sentence given by the proper author. So such kind of exam such kind of questions may appear in the examination. So Donald Cuff told that the management is an art and science of decision making and leadership. So as per Donald Cuff, it's the art and science of taking of making the decision and the leadership. But as for Henry Fayol, management is as to manage, is to forecast and to plan, organize, to command and to coordinate and to control. So we have added the six segments. First will be the forecast, a plan, organize, command, coordinate and control. But as for Peter Drucker, the management is a multi-purpose organ that manages a business and managers, that manages business and manages managers and manages workers and work. Okay, so we need to, you know, very carefully keep it, very carefully we should keep all these things in mind. And this kind of tricky questions or this kind of confusing questions always appear in the GATE examination.